Hello everybody, today we are going to start next lesson, that is triangles. So now we are going to see some basic things which already we have seen, but then to once again we will see, that is introduction. Okay, so next all the concepts are depend on this basic, so we are going to revise in short. Okay, so see here carefully. Today we are going to start triangles. So everybody knows what is mean by triangle. Okay, triangle is a closed figure which is made up of three line segments. So we can give here any name, triangle ABC. Okay, triangle ABC, AB, BC and AC. Due to these three sides, that this figure is closed and that figure is known as triangle. Okay, so you will get three angles in that, three sides and three angles. So like that, six elements you will get for a triangle. Okay, so this is basic information about triangle that everybody knows. Okay, now depend on this, there are six types. There are six types of triangles. Three are depend on the side and three are depend on the angles. Okay, so now we are going to see types which are depend on the sides. Okay, types depend on the sides. Length of sides. Okay, so this is here. See, first triangle is given. Suppose we will give here name triangle ABC. Triangle ABC. Okay, so here suppose all the three sides, triangle side AB is equal to side AC is equal to side BC. When all the three sides of a triangle are equal, that time we say so that triangle is equilateral triangle. That is equilateral triangle. Okay, all the sides are equal, then equilateral triangle. Second, in this triangle, suppose this is triangle PQR. Here suppose PQ and PR are equal. PQ and PR, two sides are equal. That time that triangle is known as isosceles triangle. This triangle is known as isosceles triangle. Any two sides, maybe PQ and QR may be equal, but any two sides are equal in length, that time that triangle is known as isosceles triangle. And third type is, here see all the three sides are equal, here only two sides are equal, and here all the sides are different in length. Suppose this is triangle MNO and MO is equals to, is not equal to ON, is not equal to NM. Okay, when all the three sides are different in length, that time that triangle is known as scalene triangle. Okay, that triangle is known as scalene triangle. So these three types are depend on the sides, length of the sides. Now we will see types which are depend on the angles. Okay, here see first triangle, all the angles, if you observe here triangle, we will say once again here, this is triangle ABC. Angle A, angle B and angle C, all the three angles are less than 90 degree. Okay, you can see here, all the three angles are less than 90 degree. So when angle is less than 90 degree, that time what we say, acute angle. So this is triangle. So here we can say acute angled triangle. Triangle ABC is acute angled triangle. One property we have seen proof for the same, that is angle sum property. Angle sum property what says? The sum of three angles should be 180 degree. Okay, the sum of three angles is 180 degree. Okay, so here angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. So all the three angles are 90 degree, less than 90 degree. Second triangle, if you will observe here, see this angle, one angle is greater than 90 degree. Suppose this is triangle PQR, angle Q is greater than 90 degree. Okay, but other two angles are less than 90 degree. Understood? This is greater than 90, other two are less than 90. So when any one angle is greater than 90 degree, that time that triangle is known as obtuse angled triangle. Okay, so this is obtuse angled triangle. One angle is greater than 90 degree, so obtuse. All the three angles are less than 90 degree, so acute. Now last one, see, that is suppose MNO. Here angle N is 90 degree. When angle N is 90 degree, and other two angles are acute angle. Okay, when one angle out of three, one angle is 90 degree, that time we can say that triangle is a right angled triangle. Okay, one angle is 90 degree, right angle is what? 90 degree. One angle is 90 degree, that time that is right angle triangle. One angle is greater than 90 degree, obtuse angle triangle. All the three angles are less than 90 degree, acute angle triangle. Okay, already we have seen this. Okay, but just one second we are in the class. Also, we have studied in class 7, class 8, we have studied about congruency criteria. Okay, condition rules, congruency condition rules. Okay, so now we are going to study all the rules in detail. Okay, so today we are going to think about the rule that you will come to know now. We are going to discuss, we will see that, and then we will see some example, and then we will start next criteria. Okay, criteria or conditions also we can see. Now see here, there are two triangles. I am saying here this is triangle ABC and this is triangle PQR. This is triangle PQR. Okay, so now here in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC and in triangle PQR, suppose it is given that AB is equals to PQ. AB is equals to PQ. Then BC is equals to QR. BC is equals to QR. And angle B is equals to angle Q. Angle B is equals to angle Q. Means three elements of triangle ABC are given and three elements of triangle PQR are given. Now we are going to compare them. We are going to compare. Understood? What is given here? AB is equals to PQ. Means one side, this side is equal of triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Also angle B and angle Q is equal and this BC and QR is equal. Okay. Here if you will observe, here see two sides and included angle, two sides and included angle. Okay, the angle which is made up of these two sides here, angle B, also angle these two sides and angle made up of these two sides, that is angle Q. These two angles are equal, means two sides and included angle of one triangle, two sides and included angle of a triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and included angle of another triangle, that time we can say both the triangles are congruent. Both the triangles are congruent by SAS criteria. Side, angle, side. So this today we are going to see SAS criteria. Side, angle, side criteria. Okay. This side AB corresponds to PQ, BC corresponds to QR, and angle B corresponds to angle Q. Okay, so these three elements of triangle ABC are equal to the three elements of triangle PQR. So we can say both the triangles are congruent by SAS criteria, side, angle, side. Okay, so now see here, while writing we need to write in the proper order. Okay, so see, suppose I am writing here triangle ABC congruent. Congruent side means is equal to and slipping is congruent PQR, triangle PQR. Okay, but if I am going to write this AB, side AB corresponds to side PQ, because side AB and side PQ are equal. Okay, so here we cannot write AB is equals to PR. That is wrong. That is not the proper order. Okay, so here we have to write in proper way. AB corresponds to PQ. AB corresponds to PQ. Okay, so this we can write afterwards. Now see here, BC, what is given after that? Angle ABC is equals to angle AQR. Angle ABC corresponds to angle PQR. Okay, angle B and angle Q is equal. That is given. And last one, BC corresponds to QR. Okay, why AB corresponds to PQ? Why it is? Because it was given in the figure. Okay, and ABC angle PQR, that is also given. And last one is BC corresponds to QR, that is also given. Okay, so three things are given. Now we can write triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR. Triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR. Okay, this is a short theorem. Here we need to write reasons for each and every step.
Okay, why now triangle ABC, triangle PQR? By which criteria? Side angle side. Side angle side. So here we can write SA is criteria. Side angle side. Condition rule. Okay, so this way we can show SA is criteria. Understood? One more thing. Suppose practically we are going to show both the triangles are congruent. Then what we can do? Triangle ABC we can remove and we can superimpose on the triangle PQR. Okay, if it will be perfectly matched, it will be perfectly matched by side, by area, by all the manners, that time we can say triangle ABC and triangle PQR are congruent. Okay, so that way practically we can show. But theoretically, if we are going to write, that time we need to show three elements, only three. How many elements does a triangle have? Six elements, three sides and three angles. From that, we have to show three elements of one triangle and three elements of another triangles are congruent. That time we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay. Now this is one part. Now suppose we have said here triangle ABC and triangle PQR are congruent. Both the triangles are congruent. But suppose now I will say AC and PR. AC corresponds to, or AC is equals to PR. AC is equals to PR. Angle BAC is equals to angle QPR. And angle BAC means this angle is equals to this. And last one I will say angle ACB is equals to PRQ. If I will make a statement, what I am saying here, see, AC is equals to PR, angle A is equals to angle P, angle C is equals to angle R. Then is it correct? Obviously it is correct, because already we have given here proof triangle ABC and triangle PQR are congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, then all the six elements of this triangle are equal to the or corresponding to the sixth element of another triangle, which we have showed congruent. Understood? But here we need to write reason. We cannot write directly this. We need to write reason. So for that, a short word we can use, that is CPCD. CPCD. Hereby CPCD we need to write. CPCD. Now what is CPCD? CPCD means what? Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Corresponding parts. These are all corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so that we can write. So here two triangles. Why we can say this? Already we have told that two triangles are congruent. Understood? Suppose I will say here this two planes are congruent. These two planes are congruent. Then what is the meaning of this? The length of this, radius of this. Okay, these two triangles, these two planes or markers are congruent in all the manners. All the things are completely matched. Understood? Okay. If I will say these two triangles are congruent, so definitely if I will remove these two are the parts of this marker, so definitely these two are congruent. Okay. So like that, if these two triangles are congruent, then all the parts, all the corresponding parts are congruent. Okay, but while giving proof, we need to give only three things, three elements of first triangle and three elements of second. Okay, so now this was about SAS criteria. Now we are going to think, suppose how much that this order is important, how we are writing this order is important, ABC and PQR. Anyhow, we cannot write triangle ABC. If I will write triangle ABC, congruent triangle PRQ, then that is not a proper order. Understood? So that we need to take precaution. So see here, just in short I am showing here, suppose this is again ABC and triangle PQR, ABC and triangle PQR. Okay, so here suppose AB is equals to PQ, BC is equals to QR, angle B and angle R is equal, angle B and angle R is equal. Okay, or we can say AB is equals to PR. AB is equals to PR, angle B is equals to angle R, and angle BC side equals to QR. Then both the triangles are congruent by SAS criteria. Okay, But while writing, we need to take care that suppose I will see here triangle ABC congruent. Okay, which side is corresponding to side AB? PR. So that should come first. AB here I have taken. So which is corresponding PR? So that I will take here first triangle side PRQ. Okay, angle R is equal to angle B. Angle R is equal to angle B. BC is equal to RQ. Yes. Okay. So while writing, we need to think about order, how we are writing. That is also important. Okay. So this was the basic information about SAS criteria. Okay. Now we will see some examples depend on this. Okay. Okay, see here our first problem, which is depend on the SAS criteria. Okay, how to use SAS criteria, that we are going to see now. See here in quadrilateral ACBD, here quadrilateral is given. AC is equal to AD. This side AC and AD are equal. And AB bisects angle A. AB bisects angle AB. This angle is bisected due to AB, and this angle and this angle is equal. That is given. Show that triangle ABC congruent triangle ABD. Means this triangle and this angle we have to show congruent. Okay. And what can you say about BC and BD? That they are asking. Understood? So first, we need to prove that triangle ABC and ABD are congruent. Okay, so while giving proof, we need to think about which things are given. Okay, for SAS criteria or for any criteria, we need three things. So we have to collect those things. Okay, so now we will see in solution, what we will write first? Solution. We are going to think about two triangles. They have told us these two triangles we have to show congruent. So we are going to think. So first, initially we will write in triangle ABC and triangle ABD and triangle ABD. These two triangles, we are thinking about these two triangles. So first, initially we need to write. Okay. What is given? AC is equals to AD. That is given. So I am taking here side AC is equals to side AD. Why? Reason also important. Why? It is given in the question. They have told us. So given. Which things they have told us? That directly we can write by given. Understood? Second thing, what is given? Due to AB, angle A is bisected. So definitely CAB is this angle. CAB, this angle is equals to DAB, this angle. Why? AB is the bisector of angle A. That is the reason. That is also given. So here I can write CAB is equals to angle CAB. I can write DAB angle DAB. Why? AB is the bisector. Bisector means what? AB made angle AB divided angle A into two equal parts or equal angles. So bisector of angle A. AB is the bisector of angle A. So definitely angle A is divided into two equal angles. So we can say CAB. But here we need to write it properly. Directly we cannot say AB because A is divided now. So we can write CAB and DAB. So angles are equal. Okay. Now see, if I am thinking about this triangle, this and this. So which thing is same now? Third thing is required. One we got side, angle we got, one more side. So if you observe here, see AB is a side which is common for both the triangles. Which is common for triangle CAB and DAB for both the triangles. Understood? So we can write side AB is equals to AB. Why? That is common side of both the triangles. Common, that is the reason. Okay, so three things we got here: this side, angle, and side. Two sides and angle. Okay, included angle. It should be included. See here,
AC and AB, included angle is this, which is equal to the included angle of AB and AD. Okay, so two sides and included angle is equal to the two sides and included angle of another triangle. That time both the triangles are congruent under SAS criteria. Okay, so here we can say now triangle ABC congruent triangle ABV by SAS criteria or condition by SAS condition. Okay, so three things: side, angle, side. SAS. So that way only we need to write side, then angle, then side. Okay, and finally the statement. Okay, now one more question is there, that is, what can you say about BC and BD? What can you say about BC and BD? BC and BD are the sides of both the triangle, are the side of triangle ABC and ABD respectively. Okay, so what we can say, just now we have seen in the introduction, we have seen if two triangles are congruent, that time if we are proving two triangles are congruent, or we have given proof for two triangles are congruent, that time we can say all the six elements of what first triangle are congruent to the all the six elements of second triangle by the CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so that in that manner only we can say. See, we have given proof triangle ABC is congruent triangle ABD. These two triangles we have given their proof, triangles are congruent. So we can see now BC congruent BD by CPC, congruent parts of, corresponding parts of congruent. Okay, so this was very simple but basic. Depend on this, we are going to have some proofs. Okay, we will see some more examples. Okay, see here, second question is ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD is equal to BC and angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. Prove that triangle ABD congruent triangle BAC. Second, BD is equal to AC. And third one, angle ABD is equal to angle BAC. Okay, so three questions they are asking us. What is given, that you will see once again. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD is equal to BC. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AB is equals to BC. AD is equals to BC. These two sides are equal. Okay, AD and BC are equal in length. And DAB is equals to CBA. DAB means this angle. DAB is equals to CBA. CBA means this angle. Okay, these two angles are equal. What is given? AD is equals to BC, this is first thing, and then DAB is equals to ABC. DAB is equal to ABC or CBA, means angle A is equals to angle B. These two things are given, and with the help of this we have to prove that first thing, triangle ABD congruent triangle BAC. Triangle ABD means this triangle. Triangle ABD congruent triangle BAC. Triangle ABD, ABD congruent triangle BAC. Okay, so if you will observe both the triangles, first I am taking C, ABD and BAC. What is same? First I am taking here in solution in triangle ABD and triangle BAC. We are thinking about these two triangles, so I have taken triangle ABD and triangle BAC. ABD and BAC. Okay, what is same here? AD is equals to BC. AD is equals to BC, that is given. AD is equals to BC, that is why reason given. Okay, this side is equal to this side. Okay, now we are thinking about ABD. First see carefully triangles ABD and BAC. So in that, this and this is equal. Again, what is given? See, in this triangle, angle A, and in this triangle, angle B is equal. Okay, so we can say that DAB is equal to CBA. DAB angle DBA means this angle A is equal to angle B. That is angle CBA. Why? That is also given. Okay, DAB is equal to CBA. That is also given. Okay. Now third thing, what is there? See, both the triangles, this triangle and this triangle. Okay, so I am taking here this triangle. Getting everybody? This is first triangle. And this second triangle, they have told us this. Okay, see carefully triangles, then you will get answer. So this angle and this angle is equal. Both the angles are equal. Then this side and this side are corresponding, is equal. And now AB is the common side for both the triangles. AB is the common side, and common side definitely it will be equal for both the triangles. Okay, so here we can write third one, AB is equal to AB. What is the reason? Common. That is common side for both the triangles. So definitely it is equal. So three things we have now. That is AD is equal to BC. That is side. Second thing, DBA is equal to CBA. That is angle. Okay. And third thing, AB is equal to AB. So if you see here, this is first, this is second, and this is third. Okay. So side, angle, side. So we can say triangle ABD congruent triangle BAC by S side angle side condition. Two triangles are congruent, ABD and BAC. Okay, so two triangles are congruent with the help of SAS criteria. Very simple. Okay, now see second thing they are asking. Second and third are depend on this. So now what they have told us, they are asking us BD is equal to AC. Prove that BD is equal to AC. BD is what? BD and AC. BD and AC are the sides of these two triangles. BD and AC are the sides of two triangles which we have proved here congruent. Okay. So we can say directly second one, BD is equal to BC by CPCP. Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, if triangles are congruent, this triangle and this triangle is congruent, so definitely all the six remaining elements are also congruent. So by directly we can write CPCB. Now third thing they are asking us, see angle ABD is equal to angle BAC. Okay, this we have to prove. Why? We have to write reason. ABD means this angle. ABD is equal to BAC, this BAC. Okay, again the same reason, CPCP, because already we have proved there these two triangles are congruent. So these are the remaining elements. So definitely all the elements are going to be congruent only. So here also we can write CPCP. Okay, so here these two are depend on the first. Okay, here one thing we need to understand, that whatever triangles they are asking, okay, so see carefully triangles. If triangles are clear, which triangles they are asking, then only we can correlate with the given information, and then only we will get the proof. Okay, so observe carefully and solve the same sums again in the notebook. Okay, thank you.